We continue now at the top of Daf Lamed Dalet Amud Beis and Meseches Yevamos. This is Daf 34b. The Gemara on the previous Amud said that Bebiya Rishona, by the first act of relations, a woman does not get pregnant. And so the Gemara now asks, V'ha Tamar Bebiya Rishona Yavar? But what about Tamar? This is talking about Tamar with Yehuda. Didn't she get pregnant with the first act of relations? Rashi over here says, V'ha Tamar Yavar Bebiya Rishona Mi Yehuda, her first Bia from Yehuda. Kedamar Lekamon, like we're going to say later on, De'er V'onan, she was with Aaron Onan first. Shelo Kedarkon, so they had relations, but it was not the normal way of relations, meaning it was relations from the back, and therefore that was not the normal relations, the normal act of relations, and therefore again, it seems like Tamar became pregnant from Bia Rishona. And the Gemara says, Amar Le, so he said to him, Tamar Be'etzba Ma'acha. As Rashi over here says, Be'etzba Ma'acha, she used her finger, and she was able to make it that she no longer had the hymen Kodem Bia. Before the act of relations, Upischa Basuach, she opened up the entryway. V'havale Kebez Bia. So already since she used her finger, so that's already number one, and really she got pregnant on Bia number two. The Yomer Rabbi Yitzchak, because Rabbi Yitzchak said, Kol Moachos Shel Beis Rebbe, Tamar Shimon, all of the Moachos, Rashi over here says, Kol Moachos Shel Beis Rebbe, HaMashiros Besulehen Betzboseyen, they would remove their Besula, their virginity with their fingers, Tamar Shimon, so they're called Tamar, they're all referred to that Al Shem Tamar. Why? Because of Tamar. They're named after Tamar, Shemoacha Betzbo, that's what she did, she used her finger for that purpose. The Gemara continues, Vahava Erva Onan, but what about Erva Onan? This is again what Rashi mentioned, that Er and Onan also seem to have had relations with Tamar, so it wasn't even Bia Rishona. And to that the Gemara says, no, Erva Onan, Shimshushlo Kedarkon. Again, Er and Onan, they had relations with her, but it was not in the normal fashion. It was from the back, not in the normal fashion of relations, and therefore that did not count as an act of relations for this purpose. And the Gemara continues, Meisve, we have the following question. Kol Esrim V'Yarbo Chodesh, Dosh Mi Befnim V'Zora Mi Bachutz, Divrei Rabbi Eliezer. For all 24 months, this is referring to all 24 months that a woman is nursing her child, so you shouldn't have relations in the normal fashion according to Rabbi Eliezer. Instead, what you should do is, you should have the relations, but don't deposit, so to speak, in the body of the woman. You should Zora Mi Bachutz. You should do that outside when you pull out from the woman. That's the opinion of Rabbi Eliezer. Rashi over here says, Dosh Mi Befnim V'Zora Mi Bachutz, Kedesh. The point is, you want to make sure she does not become pregnant. What's going to happen is, if she's pregnant while she's also nursing, it's going to cause, it's going to be dangerous, it's going to cause death. And therefore, again, that's Rabbi Eliezer's opinion, what you should do for those 24 months. So the Braisa continues, Amru lo, so they said back to Rabbi Eliezer, Halolu eino elo kemaisa erva onan. That act, what you're describing of dosh mi befnim and zora mi bechutz, that's what Aaron Onan did. That's something that's prohibited. How can you say that that's what you do? And so in any case, what do you see over here? You see that Erva Onan actually did have normal relations. It was just Dosh Mi Bifnim, V'Zora Mi Bachutz. It goes against what we said, that they were Shimshu Shalo Kedarkon. Rashi over here says, Ela Kamaisa Erva Onan, Alma Tamar Pesach Pasuach Hayala. You see that if Erva Onan, if that's the way they had these relations, so then Tamar was Pesach Pasuach. Tamar, again, she should have been in a situation where it was not considered Bia Rishona. And so the Gemara says, Kamaisa Erva Onan, V'lo Kamaisa Erva Onan. In this Braisa, it means it was like Erva Onan, but not exactly like Erev Onan. What does that mean? Kemaisa Erev Onan, dechsiv, it was like Aaron Onan, as the Pasuk says, V'haya imbal eshes achiv v'shiches arza. Again, it says over there that when he had this relations, so then it was shiches arza, he deposited it on the earth. That's true, that was the same thing that he's talking about over there. V'lo kemaisa Erev Onan, but it's not exactly like Aaron Onan, d'iluhasim shelo kedarka, because over there, it really was relations shelo kedarka, again, not in the normal fashion, v'hacha kedarka, but of course, over here, with Rabbi Eliezer, we're talking about Kedarka. And the Gemara continues, Bishlama Onan. I understand Onan. It says that right in the Pasuk that he did it in this fashion of Dashmi Bifnim and Zorami Bachutz, Dechsibbe Vashiches Arza. The Pasuk says, Vashiches Arza, he destroyed it to the earth. He destroyed it towards the ground. Elo Er Minolan, but Er, where do we see in the Pasuk that he did the same thing? It doesn't say that in the Pasuk. And to that the Gemara says, Amar Rav Nachman Bar Yitzchak. Rav Nachman Bar Yitzchak says, Dechsib, because the Pasuk says, Vayomas Gamo So. He also died as if he was the same, using the word also. Afu, but Oso Misa Mace. He also died with the same type of death, meaning it was the same, he committed the same Avera. And the Gemara continues, Bishlama Onan Mishum Lo Lo Yehazar. I understand by Onan, because by Onan it says, to him was not going to be the children. Ela Er, my time of it, Hachi. But Er, why did he do this? What was the reason why he did this? And the answer was, Kedeshalo Tesaber V'yachesh Yafya. Er had different motivation. He was, again, Dashmi Bifnim and Zorami Bachutz, because he didn't want her to become pregnant and she would not look as beautiful. In other words, by Er, that was his motive. He didn't want her to become pregnant. By Onan, it was a different one. By Onan, it was because he understood that he was not supposed supposed to have children with her. And the Gemara continues, Tanu Rabbanan, the rabbis taught, Osa, it says in the Pasuk, Osa, Prat Lekala comes to exclude a Kala, a bride, Divrei Rabbi Yehuda, that's the opinion of Rabbi Yehuda, Vachachamim Omrim, Prat L'Shalo Kedarka. No, that Pasuk comes to exclude a situation of relations that is Shalo Kedarka. Now the full Pasuk over here with the word Osa is as follows. Pasuk says, V'isha Asher Yishkav Ish Osa Shechva Zera, V'rochatsu B'mayim V'tomwarov. It says that the man lays with the woman Shechva Zera, a regular act of relations, and so then they're both going to be Tameh, and it uses the word Osa. So the question is, what is Osa coming to exclude? And Rashi over here explains, what does it mean, Prat Lekala? We'll see Rashi first over here. Osa V'isha Asher Yishkav Ish Osa Shechva Zera, V'rochatsu B'mayim Osa Miyutahu. The word Osa is an exclusion. And so the first opinion is, Prat Lekala comes to exclude a Kala, according to Rabbi Yehuda. The point is, according to Rabbi Yehuda, when you have Bia that first time, that first act of relations, so you don't need Tvila, you don't need to immerse, there's no issue of Tumah in Bia Rishona, Kedemifarish Taima Lekamon, that we're going to explain later on. And the Chachamim say no, Osa means to exclude a case of Shalok Kedarka. And the Gemara continues, Amar Lehon Bereder Rav Nachman, Rav Nachman. Hon, the son of Rav Nachman, he said to Rav Nachman as follows, Lema Kosava Rabbi Yehuda, let us say that Rabbi Yehuda holds, HaTorah Chosa Al Tachshite Kala, that the Torah, it has mercy on the ornaments and on the jewelry of the kala. As Rashi over here says, "Al tachshite kala khalu srak shenosenes al poneo v'im titbol yavirum hamayim." Means to say, actually, specifically the makeup, not the jewelry. It means to say the makeup that she's putting on her face. If we're going to say she becomes tamei, now she's going to have to immerse in water, and all of that is going to come off, and that's going to be something that is not going to be pleasant for her. And maybe that's what Rabbi Yehuda was saying, that a kala doesn't have this tumah because the Torah had mercy on the kala because, again, she's adorned herself. So Amar Lei, so he said back to him, no, lefisha ain isha misaberes mi bia rishona. No, the real reason is because a woman does not become pregnant from bia rishona. That's the real reason for Rabbi Yehuda. As Rashi over here says, lefisha ain isha misaberes mi bia rishona, velo shechva zera karinan be. It's not called shechva zera dein roi lazri. If it's not shechva zera that can make a person pregnant, that's not called shechva zera. Umiu miuta mi shechva zera lo nafka. Now, the exclusion is not coming from the term in the pasuk of shechva zera. However, hai mokom roi lazriahu be bia shnia, because the area where it's happening is an area where you really could have pregnancy theoretically with, if it would be the second bia. Now also, don't say that she's tummy because she's touching shechva zera. The tumas beis hastarim lo matami, because the rule is if it touches the inner hidden parts of the body, that's not tummy. Elash gzeres hakosuv bebia, it's just a gzeres hakosuv by relations, nothing to do with touching the shechva zera. V'cheinu meseches nida, and that's exactly what it says also in meseches nida. So in any case, that's what he answered him. He said the real reason why there's no tumah according to Rabbi Yehuda, it's because ain isha misaberes mi bia rishona. And so the Gemara continues, b'maika miflagi. So what are they arguing about over here? Meaning, what are Rabbi Yehuda and the Chachamim arguing about? Rabbonan savri shechva zera. Rabbonan say that the term in the pasuk of shechva zera, prat l'hara, that comes to exclude hara. Rashi over here says l'hara shelo hizriya. It means to say hara means there's an act of relations, but there's no zera. Ilamandam or nishika, ilamandam hachnasas atara. What is hara exactly to machloka? Some say it's just a kissing, a touching, so to speak, of the two bodies. Some say it's just an entry of the very top of the aver of the man. But in any case, it's a kind of bia where there is no shechva zera. That's what Rabbanan say it comes to exclude. The word shechva zera comes to exclude hara. And osa prat l'shalo kedarka. And the word osa, again, that comes to exclude a situation of shalo kedarka when there's relations in the not normal or the abnormal fashion. Rabbi Yehuda Savar, Rabbi Yehuda says, no, shalo kedarka v'hara, both shalo kedarka and hara, mi shechva zera nafka. Both of those are learned from shechva zera. And osa prat l'kala, and the word osa therefore comes to exclude a kala. As Rashi over here says, shalo kedarka v'ara mi shechva zera nafka, shalo kedarka eino mokom zera. If it's shalo kedarka, again, it's relations, but it's from the backside, so that's not called a mokom zera. That's not shechva zera. Hara lach lav shechva zera, and also hara is not shechva zera, like we said. De ein kan zera, there's no zera. Hilkach tarvayu mi shechva zera mimiti. So in other words, that's what he's saying. He's saying both of those can be excluded from shechva zera, according to Rabbi Yehuda, and that's why osa is prat l'kala. That's why that excludes the kala. And the Gemara continues, Kiyasa Ravin Amar Rav Yochanan. When Ravin came, he said in the name of Rav Yochanan, Kol Sheshoasa Achar Bala Eser Shonim Venisis. Let's say a woman delays for 10 years after she leaves her husband. Let's say her husband dies or they divorce. 10 years and she doesn't get married for 10 years. She only gets married after 10 years. Shuv Eina Yoledes. At that point, if she hasn't had relations, she hasn't had a husband for 10 years, she's not going to give birth any longer. Amar Rav Nachman, and Rav Nachman says, Lo Shanu Elashein Daitel Hinasi. That's only true if she didn't have intention to get married, if she wasn't thinking about getting married during the interim time period. But if she had an intention to remarry that whole time, or during that time, so then she will be able to become pregnant. Amar le Rava lebas Rav Chista. Now Rava said to the daughter of Rav Chista, the daughter of Rav Chista was the wife of Rava, and he said to her, "Kamaranani Rabbanan Abasrech," that the Rabbanan, they're starting rumors about you, as Rashi over here says, "Abasrech sheshoisa eser shanim achar baalech harishon v'Rami Barchama." However, your first husband was Rami Barchama. You waited 10 years. You only married me after 10 years, and yet you became pregnant. So the Rabbanan are starting rumors about you. How is it possible that you became pregnant? So Amrulay, so she said to him, "I know that toya Allah Havai. I was always thinking about you. I always knew that eventually I would marry you." And so therefore, again, if the woman is thinking about that marriage, that is sufficient that she couldn't get pregnant. And the Gemara continues, Ahida Asya Lakami de Rav Yosef. There was a woman who came before Rav Yosef. Amrulo, she said to him, "Rebbe, ano shohisi achar bali eser shanim violadati." Rebbe, you should know, I delayed after my husband, after I left my husband for 10 years till I again had relations, and I was able to give birth. Amrulo, so he said to her, "Biti, my daughter, al totsi Laz al divrei chachamim. Don't say these rumors or these false accusations about the words of the sages. That's actually impossible. It can't be that you really delayed 10 years and you became pregnant." Amrulay, so she said to him, "Indeed, that's the case. Lenachri nevalti. I did indeed have relations in the interim to a non-Jew." In other words, she admitted that what she had said was not true. And the Gemara continues. Amar Shmuel. Shmuel says, "Vekulan," and all of these women, we'll see Rashi in a minute. Tzrichos lahamten shlosha chadashim. They need to wait the 3 months in order again to determine where the child came from. Chutz migiyo. Except for a Gioris, a convert, or a woman who was a slave and was freed while being a minor, they do not have to wait 3 months. But if you have a minor who is Jewish, she actually would need to wait the 3 months. We'll take a look at Rashi over here. Amar Shmuel v'kulon hanoshim shenivalu, all these women, let's say all these women have relations. So tzrichos lahamtin milihinosei shlosha chadashim achar biyosan. If a woman has relations, she needs to wait 3 months in order to get married, because again, if she gets married too early, we're not going to know where the child came from. Chutz migiyores umishochreres ketan, except for a giyores, a convert, or a woman who was freed from being a slave as a minor. V'avagav destam ovedes kochavim v'shivcha zonos. Now, even though most non-Jews and most maidservants are considered zonos, it's considered like they had relations all along. Logazu rabbanon b'ketana lahamten achar tzvilas giyores umishochreres klum. But when it comes to a minor, so let's say the minor immerses to convert, or again is freed from being a slave, they did not make a gezeira that the ketana needs to wait immediately after that. She doesn't need to wait at all because she is a katana. Even though if she would be an adult, she would certainly have to wait. By the katana, the chachamim did not make a gezeira. Umidukamar Shmuel chutz migioris katana. Now, from the fact that Shmuel says, with the exception of a gioris katana that does not need to wait, mechlal de kulan de kamar katnas namikoi. Sounds like all the people we're talking about are minors. De katana bas yisrael tzrich lahamten. And that sounds like if it was a minor who was Jewish, she would need to wait the 3 months. V'avagav de laf bas bonim him. Even though when she's a minor, she can't have children anyway, so what's the purpose of waiting? V'en kan have chana. There's no purpose to distinguish between the child from the first or the second. Still, gozer barabbanan misham gedola. Still, the rabbanan made a gezer. They made a decree because of a situation by an adult where you do have to wait. So, by the ketana bas yisrael as well, they have to wait 3 months. And the Gemara says, uvemai. Now, when we're talking about this ketana bas yisrael, bimai, meaning, as Rashi says, bimai nafka mibalo kama, how was she leaving her first husband? What is the case over here exactly? That she's leaving her first husband and then she has to wait. Iba miyon, if we're talking about when she uses miyon, again, that's talking about when a minor is married off, not by her father, but by her mother or her brother. It's a situation where there is no father. So in that situation, it's a marriage midrabbanan, and she can refuse the marriage. If we're talking about miyon, v'amar Shmuel, but Shmuel said to Loboy that you don't require any waiting after miyon. V'ibeget, and if we're talking about a situation where she was divorced through a get, ha'amar Shmuel chadazimna, that Shmuel already said. D'amar Shmuel, because Shmuel said, miyon abo eino tzricha, that if it comes to a case of miyon, she doesn't need to wait. She doesn't need to wait shlosha chadashim 3 months. But nasan laget. But if he gives her a get, tzricha lahamtin shlosha chadashim, she does need to wait 3 months. Rashi over here says, "Iba miyon hamar Shmuel de lo boy amtune." When it comes to miyon, Shmuel said she doesn't need to wait. The lekel amigzar mishum gedola. We don't have to make a decree because of a gedola. The in gedola yotzes b'miyon, because a gedola, there's no concept of miyon by a gedola. So in other words, the point of Shmuel's statement was, if she does something that does not even exist by a gedola, she doesn't need to wait the 3 months. But if she receives a get, that's something that does exist by a gedola, so she needs to wait the 3 months. So in any case, it can't be that Shmuel is talking about any of those cases, because either it's not true or Shmuel already said it. So what does he mean exactly? Ela biznus. So the Gemara says, rather, we must be talking about a situation of znus. She wasn't married at all. It was just a situation of znus. It was just a situation where she was having relations without being married. And we'll continue with this discussion in the next video on Daf Lamed Hey Amud Aleph.